Hello, everybody. This broadcast is brought to you by the strange, the bizarre, the unusual. I like it. My name is Roger Hanson, and I'm here to present to you another story out of this series that we like to call Strange Universe. I'm going to forego my usual introductory statement, and because of the length of the stories, I'd also like to tell everybody that if we can't get the story into the 15 minutes that we make our videos, don't worry, we will continue the story with more parts until the story is finished. With that being said, I'd like to thank everybody for listening and begin the show. Begin the story. Thank you. This is a review of the history of psychology of werewolf killers. The serial beast. Not all serial killers who get the moniker werewolf or wolf actually behave in a wolf-like manner. Michael Lupo of London liked that his name meant wolf. He was even referred to as the Wolfman, but his murders involved strangulation. Likewise, the Wolfman of San Francisco, William Johnston, used a straight razor on his three victims during the 1930s. Rather than ripping them apart in a frenzy, since he dragged it along their bodies several times, the results had the appearance of claw marks. Two victims had been prostitutes and one had been his wife. Not all werewolves actually killed in London. Bill Ramsey first experienced a strange sensation and its accompanying foul odor when he was 9 years old. He began to think of himself as a wolf and to experience rage-filled compulsions in the form of seizures that made him snap and bite. This pain dogged him into adulthood, but he kept it under control until one night in 1983 he went to a hospital, and as he was being treated he lunged out and bit a nurse. He then ran to the corner and crouched on all fours like a wolf, growling at anyone who came near him. The police arrived to take him into custody. Several people grabbed and restrained him on a gurney until a sedative could be administered. From there, he was taken to a psychiatric institution. It was not clear what should be done for him. Steiger described how demonologist Ed and Lorraine Warren soon got involved with the case. They proposed that Ramsey was possessed by a werewolf demon that needed to be exorcised. With the family's permission, they invited Bishop Robert McKenna to perform it. They all gathered in Connecticut for the ritual, along with four police officers, just in case things got out of hand. It was said that Ramsey possessed great strength, and they feared what could happen should he become possessed, break free, and escape. During the ceremony, a crucifix was applied to part of Ramsey's body while Latin incantations were said. Ramsey apparently thought the rituals was bogus before it began, but supposedly the bishop recognized the demon spirit inside the man. The ritual lasted for half an hour as the bishop commanded the demon to leave Ramsey's body. The officers restrained Ramsey when he tried to attack McKenna, but eventually, as described in the Warren's book, Werewolf, he experienced a force leaving his body. Supposedly, he found peace from the demons and was free thereafter from any further possession. It is not clear whether there was much follow-up, so as to note whether Ramsey was genuinely cured. Even so, the ceremony might merely have had a powerful psychological effect on him. As such, he might have come to believe strongly enough in his religious purification that he was able to go on with his life. That is the end of that review. If you have any comments that you would like to make, please feel free to make any comments that you wish to make. As I've said before, we respect everybody's opinion, and nobody has ever been banned or blocked for making any comments that other people on our sites don't feel is appropriate. We respect each and every person's opinion. All we ask is to show some respect. If there's something that you disagree with, please respect the other person's opinion. And if somebody says something that's out of line to you and you are really, really irritated by it and you want to respond, show some restraint. And the best way to handle it is to go take your mouse and click on the like button of the post that they made an offensive comment towards to show your support to it. That's the best way to do it. Just show your support for it. And again, like I said, if you like what you've heard and you want to hear more and you wish to be a part of it, subscribe and like my posts, the channel, or the groups, or the communities. We are more than happy to have you with us. And again, I'd wish each and every one of you a strange, bizarre, and unusual day that you can share with your friends like we're sharing with you right now. Thank you.